We're going to do Victorian Numberphile today. So I'm going to be a Victorian, and as a Victorian, I'm very concerned about the future of the nobility. I don't know about you, but I'm very concerned that the aristocracy might die out, that the family names might die out. Apparently, this was something that the Victorians were concerned about. So they wanted to know the probability that a family name might die out. Or to put it another way, they wanted to know the probability of extinction. It's kind of the same idea. So let's have a look at the maths of extinction. So let's have a guy up here at the top of the family tree, Sir Lemon of the noble Lemon family. So he wants to know if his family name will survive. So I've got this die here, which is going to generate how many kids this person has. Or if I'm more technical, it's going to generate how many sons this person has. If we treat family names in the traditional way, which is not necessarily true, but the idea that a family name is passed from father to son and then passes on to their son.
Mr. and Mrs. Wilhelm of Sullivan, Illinois, that's in America, have a family of 13 sons, all boys.
So this is going to generate how many sons this person has. So they could have three, or he could have two, he could have one son, he could have zero children. And I've got zero here again and zero here again.
All you parents who want boys and get girls must blame it on Mr. and Mrs. Wilhelm. Nature has to strike an average somehow.
Let's do the first generation. Let's see how many kids he will have. He has three kids. So he has three sons that are going to pass on the family name. Now we're going to see in turn how many kids they have. For the first one, he has one more son there. The second son has two. Two sons. Great. And the third son, let's see how many kids he has. And he has one. So they're doing quite well. So we're going to pass the name down another generation. Ah, now, no kids. So we've got no kids here. So that's the end of that branch of the family tree. Let's do the other children here. Let's see how many kids they have. Okay, we've got two kids here. And, oh, the family line has ended there. And let's do this child. I haven't done this person yet. Let's see how many kids they have. Oh, three. So that's nice and healthy. So we've got three more kids here. Let's do the next kid. Oh, unfortunately, that branch is now dead too. So we're all down to these last three kids here. Let's see how they go. Oh, good. We've got two kids here, zero here, and all three. We're doing quite well. Zero. That's a dead end. Oh, zero again, I'm afraid. That's a dead end. Zero again. Oh dear, this generation's not doing as well. Zero again.
Oh, no.
So there's all down to one last kid here to pass on the family name. Oh, and they had no children. So this family has gone extinct. Or the family name has gone extinct. Now I'm going to use a different die. So on this die, I've got, we could have three kids. We've got two kids here, one, another one, and a zero. So it's slightly different probabilities for this one.
Makes you feel optimistic about the future of the human race, doesn't it? 17's a number.
Let's see how it goes. Sir Lee Temple. All right, here we go. Oh, so the first generation, just one kid. Let's carry on. Three kids for the next generation. One, two, and three. And let's do another one. Oh, three. So not too bad after all. So this is another healthy generation. So we can keep going, keep going. This seems like a bigger family. But is this family going to survive? I mean, I don't know yet. I mean, I would have to do the maths. I would have to work out the probability that this family is going to survive. In fact, there is a nice way to work out if a family is going to go extinct. It's actually quite simple. And it's just based on your average. The average number of kids will tell you when your family will go extinct. In fact, if your average number of kids is less than or equal to one, you are guaranteed to go extinct. If it's greater than one, you may go extinct, it's not guaranteed. But if it's less than or equal to one, absolutely guaranteed to go extinct. Now, I think this is slightly surprising. When I tell you that fact, I think that feels intuitively right, actually. I think that feels like, oh yeah, that makes sense. But I don't think you would work that out without having to go through the maths and prove that that's true.
Mr. Miller, a confirmed bachelor, left $750,000, £155,000 in our money, to the Toronto mother who should have the most babies in the 10 years following his death.
Okay, let's look at these dice I've been using. This last example, which was the very healthy family I had over here on the right, let's look at the probabilities. So we've got the number of kids here. Let's have a look. Well, you could have zero kids. You could have one, two, three. In a different experiment, we could have four, five. So we could carry this on further. What was the probability of having zero kids? Well, it's just one out of six. What was the probability of having one? Well, there was a one and a one. It was two out of six. Probability of having two. Well, there was a two and a two. So two out of six. And the probability of having three. It was just one. One out of six. So the average number of kids, well, I just add up the values here and divide by six. Nine out of six would be the average. It's greater than one. And this is going to be a very healthy family. I think that makes sense. If your average is greater than one, the population is going to be growing. I think that makes sense. So you could be unlucky. You could go extinct. You could have a generation where you have no kids. You could go extinct. But generally, you expect your population to grow. We compare that to the other example. So three out of six, probability of having zero kids. One out of six for one kid. One out of six for having two kids. One out of six for having three kids. So what's my average this time? I add up these values. Six divided by six. So the average is one. Okay, from that. Do you know, I don't know if that means my population is going to be growing or not growing. I'm not sure about that at the moment. There is another example we could have done, maybe a worse example. This is where the average is less than one. Just to show you what I've got. So zero kids, I've got three out of six. One kid, yeah, I've got one and a one. So that's two out of six. Two kids, I've got one of those. That's one out of six. I don't have a three on this, so that's it. So the average is four divided by six, which is less than one. I think it makes sense that this would have a dwindling population. Over time, the population would be getting smaller and you would go extinct, probably go extinct. But it's guaranteed that you go extinct. That's the thing. You are guaranteed to go extinct if your average is less than one. The borderline case, when the average is equal to one, you're guaranteed to go extinct. Which might not be so obvious.
And did an half keep her busy, what with the washing and the feeding of them all and that? Come along now, jump to it. Tallest at the back, shortest in the front. In single file, fall in.
So what we're going to do to prove this is we're going to turn these probabilities that I've written out into a formula. I'm going to have the probability of no kids, which is 1/6, plus 2/6, which is probability of one kid, x, plus probability of two kids, that's 2/6, x squared, plus probability of three kids, that's 1/6, x cubed. Can you see the formula I've made out of this? I've made a formula and I've used the probabilities as the coefficients. Now I'm going to call this formula, I'm going to give it a name, g of x. Okay, so that's the name of this formula. Now here's the important thing about the formula, about g. If I'm interested in the probability of extinction by generation n, right, sometime in the future, this is equal to g of the probability of extinction by generation n minus 1. So I've slightly reduced the problem. Now that's not an obvious thing, but I've slightly reduced the problem by one generation, if you can see that. If I do have chance to, I might be able to justify this in a second, but I don't want to get caught up in this yet. This is the clever part, is I'm going to let n tend to infinity. So I'm going to go far, far into the future. If I let n tend to infinity, on the left-hand side, this is going to be the probability of ultimate extinction. At some point, far in the future, I am going to go extinct. That's the probability I'm interested in. On the right-hand side, this becomes g of, and this expression here is also the probability of ultimate extinction. It's the same thing if we let n go to infinity. Or to put it another way, what we've got here is x equals g of x. If I can solve this for x, I will have the probability of ultimate extinction. Let's do one of our examples and just to see how this works. So my g of x in my first example was this, and I'm trying to solve this equal to x. Well, you just solve that. I mean, there's lots of ways to solve this. I won't go through the details of solving it. And you will get two solutions. I'll tell you what they are. They are x equals 0.30 and 1. But it's the smallest one we want. The smallest solution is the probability of ultimate extinction. So for this dice that I was using, the probability of ultimate extinction was about 30%. If I did it for a really long time, I'm not expecting to go extinct. I have a 30% probability that I will go extinct. Let's have a look at when you are guaranteed to go extinct. Let's compare that with the other dice. So I had my g of x for my example. I'm going to draw the graph for g of x. So there's your y-axis, there's your x-axis. On this graph, I'm going to draw in the y equals x line there, dotted. If x was equal to 0, most of those terms cancelled out. And the only term I had left was the probability of no kids. It was 1/6. So when x is 0, you're crossing the y-axis at this point. If x is equal to 1, then what happens is g of x just becomes adding all the probabilities together. If you add all the probabilities together, you always get 1. That's always guaranteed to happen. So this point is always on my curve g. This is the point 1, 1. That's always going to be there. And then if I draw the graph of g, it looks like this. It curves upwards like this. So this is my graph g of x. And this is true in general. When your average is greater than 1, it's always going to curve up this way. It's always going to cross the y equals x line twice. Here at 1, because that always happens. And this one here, the smaller one, was the probability of extinction. Now let's compare that with the average equal to 1 or less than 1. Let's look at the graphs.
The other dice.
Yeah, the other dice. Same thing. There's my y equals x line. And I'm going to draw what g looks like. So if the average was equal to 1, tends to look like this. So you'd have a probability here. You're always going to have the probability 1, 1, or the point 1, 1. And then the curve of g comes up. It's always increasing like that. Just kind of touches that point there and moves off. Now, the probability of extinction is when it crosses the y equals x line. In this example, I had it crossed twice. I needed the smaller one. In this example, it only ever crosses once. Well, it just touches the point 1, 1, which means that the probability of extinction is 1, because it's the only time we cross that line. And that's the thing we need to know. Probability of extinction is equal to 1, which means you're guaranteed to go extinct. And just to show our third example, we got the y and x axis, we got a y equals x line. We're crossing the y axis somewhere. We know we crossed the point 1, 1. And I'm going to draw in the curve g. And this is for the average less than 1. What happens here is we're kind of curving upwards again, and we cross through that point, which is the point x equals 1, which again is the probability of extinction, which means you are guaranteed to go extinct. This is all true in general. There's only one exception to what I've said, which is this dice. And this is the one which has a 1 on every side. And if I roll this, I could roll it forever. I would never go extinct. But the average for that die is 1. So that's our one exception to what I told you. So there was this thing that I said, and I didn't quite justify it straight away. But let's try and justify it. So I had this. This was the important thing. The probability of extinction, let's say, by generation n